Hello, my name is Nurse Pauline RN. Welcome to my channel. The goal of my channel is to assist nursing students to be successful in their fundamentals of nursing exam. Today we're going to be talking about immobility and inactivity. One of the physiological effects of immobility is plantar flexion, which reflects in ambulation. When moving a patient up in bed, both nurses should stand even at the patient's shoulder. Patients with DVT of the leg, assess and measure the calf. Patients getting out of bed, first you check the patient's baseline blood pressure. Legs should be dangled before walking. Patients with new paralysis on one side of the body, assess the extremity for unilateral swelling and atrophy. Prevent blood clot. The doctor will order heparin or Lovenox. Immobilized patients with inadequate fluid intake may be at risk for thrombosis formation, impaired skin integrity, respiratory infections, constipation, UTI, urinary tract infection. Signs and symptoms of immobilized atelectasis is decreased breath sounds. Patients should have passive ROM, range of motion exercises performed as soon as moving extremity is lost. Assisting the transfer from bed to stretcher. Assist the situation for potential unsafe complication. When giving care to a patient in bed, side rails on the opposite side should be up. If you are giving care on the left side, the side rails on the right side should be up, the opposite side. Elements of normal movements. 1. Body alignment. 2. Positive joint mobility. 3. Balance. 4. Coordinated movements. Center of gravity is point where most of the weight is concentrated for a body or an object. BMR, basal metabolic rate, is the rate which a person uses energy when the body is at rest. Exercise involving muscle contraction with resistance varying at consistent rates are isokinetic exercises. Example, using stationary machines at the gym. These are isometric exercises. Isokinetic exercises are exercises involving muscles contracting with resistance varying at constant rates. This would be an example of a stationary bike at the gym. And this is isokinetic exercise. First step to assess the body alignment of an alert patient, a mobile patient, assess that the patient is at ease. When assisting with an obese patient to stand, assess the client's weight and consider asking another nurse for help. nurse helping with patients with unilateral paralysis to walk. Stand on the affected side and hold the arm around the waist. When walking a patient with unilateral side weakness, you should use a 2-point of support are kept on the floor at all times. When walking a patient with unilateral side weakness, 2-point of support are kept on the floor at all times. And we'll talk about your 2-point crutches further. If patient complains of dizziness, syncope while ambulating, first lower the patient gently to the floor. One of the principles of ROM, range of motion exercises, is to provide support for distal joints. If a patient is starting to fall while ambulating, gently lower the patient to the ground. Principle of body mechanics, flex the knees, keep feet wide apart. Lower intensity activities need to be done more often for value. Care plan for activity intolerance. 1, consult members of healthcare, example PT, physical therapy or occupational therapy or social worker. 2, involve the family. Consider the patient's activity. Increase activity level. Patients with foot drop, we use a foot board. I've seen an exam where we can use a clean sneakers in bed. Scoliosis is curvature of the spine. Range of motion exercises enable one to move joint to full extent. Lordosis is abnormal anterior curvature of the lumbar spine. Urinary stasis is urinary accumulation leading to urinary tract infection. Balance or stability provided by feet and their positioning is called base of support. Log rolling, maintain alignment of the spine while turning and rolling patients. Catabolism is breakdown of more complex substances into simpler ones to release energy. Crepitation or crepitus is grating of the ends of the bones. Embolism is blood clot. Permanent immobile joint is called ankylosis or ankyloid joint. When patient is getting out of bed, dangle feet first before standing. Check patient's blood pressure before walking. When lifting a patient, 1, foot should be wide base of support. 2, foot at wide stance. 3, proper alignment is necessary. 4, avoid bending. 5, keep object close. When taking care of patient in bed, 1, raise the level of the bed. Save your bags. 3, push instead of lift. Always ask for help. When walking patients, reward patients while walking. You find the patients doing better, hopefully the second time. Always reward your patients. Use overhead trapeze bar to help patient change positions while in bed and in transferring from bed to chair. Patient with osteoporosis is at risk for pathological fractures. Physical exercises enhance cardiopulmonary and musculoskeletal function. Patient diagnosed with DVT, deep vein thrombosis, do not massage legs. If the patient is diagnosed with DVT, do not massage legs. TED hose or support hose is contraindicated for patients with open wounds. 2, new skin graft. 3, assess pulse before putting hose on your patient. If pulse is very diminished or absent, notify the doctor. Patients should have 2000 mLs of fluids daily. Prevents kidney stones. Patients with kidney stones, the doctor will order for us to strain the patient's urine for stones. CBR means complete bed rest. Diet for immobility is high protein, high calorie, high vitamin B, high vitamin C. Patients in restorative care, example rehab, we will assist them with their ADLs, activities of daily living, ROM, range of motion exercises. We'll assist them with using their walkers, crutches, and canes. Doctor will have ordered physical therapy and occupational therapies for these patients. Patients with passive range of motion exercises, stay close to the joint to assist with exercises. Use cupped hands under heels. Example of isometric exercise. Isometric is yoga. Always review doctor's orders concerning positioning your patients and mobility. High fuller position is 60 to 90 degrees. For patients with dyspnea, we'll use it when we're feeding our patients. Prevents aspirations. Hit the like button, please. Hit your subscribe button. Please share my videos and comment below. Have a good day. I'll see you in my next video following this video on positioning patients and crutches, wheelchair, walkers, canes. Thank you. Have a blessed day.